Hello everyone, and welcome to our session here on one of my favorite tools for annotation and markup and note-taking and sticky notes and all of those great aspects is Diggo, D-I-G-G-O. If you go to the website, www.diggo.com, it's very easy. It's free. There's some paid features which we'll get to in a little bit. This is a great tool for you to create groups, create classes, where students can basically now annotate and mark up online text and share them with you and with each other. So before we proceed, and how this is a great tool for Common Core close reading, let's view the company's overview video so give you a better sense of what this product can do.
Diggo is a cloud-based personal information management system. Diggo provides you with tools on all major web browsers, Android, iPad, and iPhone, to help you to collect and access a variety of information. All the items you collect from anywhere go into My Library on the Diggo server. That is in the cloud, so you can access from anywhere. First of all, Diggo offers great tools while reading online. Diggo allows you to add digital highlights and interactive sticky notes, as seen in this demo. With Diggo Browser add-on installed, select any text to highlight. You can even choose different highlighter colors. Because all the information you collect is stored in the cloud, all these highlights will stay on the page when you revisit, even from any computer or device like an iPad. Here is the same highlighted page accessed from your iPad. Now you can continue on iPad where you left off on your PC and continue adding annotations. Through Diggo Web Highlighter for iPad, you can highlight on your Safari just like on iBooks. For those who consume a lot of online information, Diggo's highlights and sticky notes are indeed great for active e-reading and better retention. When you bookmark a page to Diggo, you can organize by tags, which makes things easy to find. Mark to read later. Choose to upload and archive an entire web page forever through Snapshot, so you will never have to worry about things you found no longer being there. The page is saved as HTML as well as an image. Besides saving useful web pages, the new Capture feature allows you to capture, annotate a screenshot with shapes, arrow, and text. This is very useful when you want to save a screenshot for yourself or share visual notes with others easily. Of course, all this data is stored in the cloud in My Library. When you are on the go, you can access your Diggo library through any mobile platform that Diggo supports. With Diggo PowerNote for Android, you can browse through your library or pages marked Read Later while standing in line. Jot down your ideas. Take pictures of things you like to keep or research later. With Diggo PowerNote for Android, you literally have a photographic memory. Similarly, you can access your bookmarks through Diggo Offline Reader for iPhone. Download pages to read offline when there is no internet access. More new Diggo iPhone apps will be coming soon, so stay tuned. Diggo Evolution. Diggo has evolved over the past few years from a simple online bookmarking tool to incorporating web annotation, to enabling knowledge sharing and group-based collaborative research, and finally moving closer to our ultimate vision to provide our users with the best cloud-based information management tool for collecting, organizing, and accessing any information anywhere. To learn more about Diggo, please check out our other video tutorials.
Okay, great. So now you have a better sense of what Diggo can do. Let's look at some examples, some aspects, and talk about a little bit about what it can do for Common Core close reading. So here we go. I have a lot of things here. Now, what I did here is once you create your account on Diggo, you can install a an applet, it's an extension, something for your own web browser. Okay, Digo really works best when you're reading text online from a web browser, meaning from Google Chrome, from Internet Explorer, from Firefox, from Safari, your top internet browsers. Okay, so once you have that set up, basically what happens is, like, I'm using Google Chrome. If you look up here in the upper right hand corner, there's this little D here. And now this will be Explorer. It's very, very similar. So whenever you're reading a web page now, you can sort of now annotate it and capture things and look at aspects. And it works really, 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 really great. So let me just, for example, I'll go to a web page. This is a web page. It's a document. It's Lincoln's second inaugural address, one of my favorite documents. This is a great, great, great inaugural address for historical value, for literary value as well. And say now I'm a student and I'm doing some research and I want to mark this up and share this with my classmates and with my teacher. How do I go about marking this up? Well, now once I have my document here in my web browser, I hit the little D up here. Okay. Now this pops down, and now you have some options. Should I annotate it? Should I save this? Should I read it later? Can I share the page? So let's do annotate, and now you have some options here. There's some highlighting options. Okay. There's also add a sticky note option, and there's also you can save it to your Digo library to read it later. So we want to do some annotating. Maybe we'll pick yellow. Just keep it simple for now. And you're reading the document and you're looking for key ideas, key phrases, whatever you outline for your particular assignment. And this is a wonderful, wonderful piece. And the last line here is one of the most famous lines of any inaugural address. And you just click it. Okay, wow, with malice towards none, with charity for all. It's a wonderful, wonderful passage. Right here, Lincoln has a lot of references to God. So if you kind of highlight this, and you can, just highlight, and you can choose the color. You can always change the color. This sort of pops up, and you can change it to like pink, all right, which is kind of neat. Whatever you want to do. So you kind of get the idea. Maybe I want to add a sticky note. I add a sticky note, and say reference. To God. I mean, we'll keep this sort of simple. Whoops, excuse me. Reference to God. And post. Now, when I post something, you're going to see something here in a moment, and I'll explain this more later. Ask you private. I have one class, APUS 05, fifth period, or a group that you're going to be in once you join is the education group. Let's keep it private for now, but then we'll explain what that means later. I post it. Okay, and now, okay, wow, so there's a sticky note. So all the things that basically we talked about before earlier here about using maybe Adobe products like Acrobat or Professional or Microsoft Word or Google Docs about highlighting, annotating, and using sticky notes, Digo actually does this in an HTML format, in a web format. So you don't even need those programs. You could do anything you want, very similar, and there's also some great sharing aspects, okay? Now, there is a problem, though, if your document is a PDF. Now, I personally post a lot of PDF files, like Adobe files, to my website that I require students to read. Since it's not truly a web page, you really can't mark up the document like I'm showing you here. Okay, let's just look for an example here. Okay, I'll go to my web page. Okay. I showed just before. And let's just use an example. I'll go to APUS History, and I'll go to my primary sources page. This password protected. Okay. So say you're posting documents to your own web page, and they're PDF files. Okay. Great, great speech. Henry, Patrick Henry, give me liberty or give me death. Okay. Let me just make it a little bit bigger here. Now, even though this is on a website, it's on a web browser, this is a PDF file. Remember, if you go down here to the bottom, remember, you can save a PDF, things like that. I can highlight, here with my cursor, but watch what happens when you try to do this with the Digo. Okay, so I do Digo, I'll do annotate, and let's just do highlighting. And let me see it. Highlighting won't work. Okay, see what's happening here? It really won't work. Okay, so now what do I do? How can I do this? There is some brief ways around it. In addition to highlighting or annotating, you could also take a screenshot of anything you want. You can capture a part of a page with Diggo, and you could add some annotations to it. So let's just kind of go down here. If you go to your Diggo, and rather than annotate, I do screenshot. Now you can do this either with a PDF file that you post online, or you can do this with any web page. So I go to screenshot. See how you get the little crosshairs here? Now you can basically capture the document that you like, that you want to maybe annotate. Okay. Now you can do some things. See how there's a rectangle box down here? There's a circle. There's some text. There's an arrow. So now, rather than highlighting text, unfortunately, you're gonna have to, do something like this. You know, great. You know, give me liberty or give me death. Right, the most famous passage of this particular speech. Maybe you put a box around it. Now you draw an arrow. Oh, arrow go the other way. So you want to draw arrow. How that reflects against peace versus peace. Now you could add some text anywhere you want on the page. You know, great. Example. I mean, I'm just using simple things. So see how you can mark it up, but you're only marking up what you capture in that screenshot. And then you can save it once you're done. I'm just gonna save it. Okay. And now it's uploading to my Diggo library. Okay, so see how that sort of works. You can only capture what's showing on your screen. So you can get around it. But again, you can also, let's go back to our Patrick Henry. You can go up to Diggo here. Now, this is saved now in my Diggo library. You can also do this idea. Let me get to the screenshot here. I go to do a screenshot. Again, I can, you know, do certain things here. Maybe I just want to do a screenshot of this particular passage. All right, and now I can do those annotation tools here as well. It's a little bit big and so forth, but then you can do your text and things of that nature, and then I just will save it, and that'll be really good. Okay, now, so you got the idea. Okay, so now what happens once you save this Diggo, document? So you go to my library, and let's just refresh this page. Okay, a little bit here. So that's what I just did. Avalon, second inaugural address, Abraham Lincoln. So look at that. It shows you, okay, the actual original website. Okay. It shows you the passages that I highlighted, and I added this, you know, things like that. It shows you my sticky note that I created. Okay. It also shows you the other highlight I did. Remember, I did a highlight in pink, and I did a highlight in yellow. That's kind of neat. If you wanted to, you could even add a sticky note from here. You could remove your highlights from here. You could remove your sticky note from here. Okay. You can also do text view, which is kind of, you need the premium account. I'm sorry. I'll get back into that to that later. Okay. You can edit it from here. Okay. It gives you a description. Right now, it's listed as private. But we can change that. You could put a description of what this particular passage was, what this particular document was. You could add tags to it, you know, like Lincoln and whatever the case may be. You can also add to a list, which means you can create lists, which basically is like folders, how you want to organize your Diggo documents, you know, maybe by class, things like that. If you're a student, that works good for you. But share to a group, okay? Now, again, you can create groups, and I'll show you how to do this in a moment, where basically now you want to do APUS. You can create groups if you're a student or if you're a teacher, and you can share this with your group. Okay, this is really kind of neat. All right, so there's a lot of things you can actually do with this. Okay, so that's really kind of a fun part of it. All right, so it's just kind of fun. There's the annotations that we actually did. Okay, so see how this works? This is a really, really nice product. So you can go to preview here. And there's the little web page. It doesn't show you annotations here, but it gives you the whole entire document. You can even share the document from here, send to somebody, and things like that, which is really, really a lot of tools here for sharing documents and creating documents, annotating documents, and things of that nature. Okay. So let's pause for a second here, and in my next screencast, I'll cover some of the ways creating groups and things of that nature. Thank you.